question. What is the word kavitam mean exactly in Nadhanam na Janam Sundari verse of the Shastrakam? Answer. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written a Sanmodan Bhashya where he explains each verse of the Shastrakam. There he explains this in two ways. One, he says Nadhanam na Janam na Sundari kavitam. So he says Dhanna Jana Sundariya, obviously meaning wealth, followers and opposite sex. And then kavitam, he says it refers to, the word kavita literally means poetry. One who is a poet is called as kavi. Kavita is the product of a poet. So this, he says, refers to the fruitive activity section of the Vedic literature, which is often described in poetic language. So in the Bhagavad Gita also Krishna says, Brihat Sam Tatha Sam Naam, that among the various songs, the Sam, Brihat Sam is a very beautiful song, and this actually glorifies the gods who are engaged, who are enjoying in great opulence material pleasures, and they are considered the ideals, the stars in the Karmakanda section. So just as Krishna says that Yamam Pushpitam Vacham, so flowery words, so similarly he says poetic words over here, and then so those poetic words and the promises which are given in the Vedic scriptures of Dhana Jana Sundari, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, no, I do not want this, so na kavitam. So another meaning he uses in a purport, he says Sundarin kavitam, one can bring it together. That actually this poetry is very attractive. But although the poetry is attractive, a devotee doesn't want it because it is temporary. And there were some other commentators also, some other Sanskrit scholars also give the example kavitam. It can simply refer to the fame of being a kavi. That when one produces kavita, there can be different kinds of pleasures in this world. So one pleasure is the pleasure of being a learned person. So scholarship, the pride and joy of scholarship that is there, now for that also. So basically kavitam can refer to either the Vedic literature which describe in poetic language sensual pleasures, or it can refer to the fame that one gets by composing kavitas and being considered to be a learned person. Both are material pleasures, and a devotee says no to all such material pleasures so that one can say fixed in devotion to Krishna, unalloyed devotion. Thank you. Hare Krishna.